Her contribution for the 8th Virtual International Conference of Community Psychology 2020 will be a presentation on gambling harm in Melbourne's cult communities and an analysis of socioeconomic indexes for areas SAFER, which is a product developed by the Australian Bureau of Statistics census data. My name is Randa Zbouh Moussa from Scorpius Interest Consulting in Sydney, and my co-presenter is Case Otsuka from Victoria University in Melbourne. The aim of this presentation is to analyze the socioeconomic indexes for areas data from the 2016 Australian Census to identify the areas in most need of social support services such as gambling counseling services in culturally and linguistically diverse communities in Melbourne area and the surrounding suburbs where migrants and cult communities reside. We're going to estimate the demographics of cult communities in these areas by looking closely, by looking at there is acculturation strategy and the ethnic identity salience and cultural identity salience framework developed by Ting Tum et al. By using the concept of the acculturation style and conflict resolution style in cult communities, it would help us in more effective and strategic planning to allocate resources, services, in Melbourne and surrounding areas. These four measures of socioeconomic indexes for areas rank areas according to their relative socioeconomic advantage and disadvantage in terms of occupation, income, education, employment, housing, and other indicators of advantage and disadvantage, such as disability, English language skills. The four measures are the index of relative socioeconomic disadvantage, the index of relative socioeconomic advantage and disadvantage, in addition to the index of education and occupation, and the index of economic resources. It can be used by government, business and communities for many purposes, such as to determine areas that require additional funding for improved services, or to identify potential business opportunities, or to research the relationship between health and education outcomes and the socioeconomic conditions of an area. Australia was identified to be one of the most multicultural nations, with more than 300 languages spoken in our homes, over 100 regions, and more than 300 different ancestries. The census highlights Australia's rich cultural diversity. More than a quarter of the Australian population were born overseas. 21% of the population had one or both parents born overseas, and nearly half of the population were at least third generation Australians. Compared to other countries such as USA, New Zealand, and Canada, Australia has a higher percentage of overseas born population. By looking at the top five overseas-born populations in metropolitan Melbourne local government areas, Dandenong, or Greater Dandenong, has the highest proportion of overseas-born across all the LGAs in metropolitan Melbourne. And I listed here the top five. The 2016 census data also identified an increase of overseas-born population from 56.1% in 2011 to 57.7% in 2016, as well as increase in proportions of speakers of other languages from 61.2% to 64.5% in 2016. Italia wide, there are more than one in five people who speak a language other than English at home. Nearly 48% of Melbournians speak a language other than English. There is a large linguistic diversity in home language in the metropolitan Melbourne areas. Mandarin, 38.8%, is the top of the list. Comes Cantonese, Indonesian, Korean, Spanish, and Hindi, Vietnamese, and Arabic, 2.7%, out of a population of 4.5 million people. I selected the highest five areas within Melbourne metropolitan LGAs of the highest number of LOT speakers, that there is a steady increase in percentage of speakers of LOT languages, greater than Dandenong, Greenbank, Monash, Melbourne, and Hume. However, when I looked at the data of people who speak little English or not at all English, there was a decrease in numbers. It may be due to various changes in the demographics of these LGAs, except for Greater Dandenong. There was an increase of people who don't speak English well or not at all, from 15.5% to 20.4%. In our study for demographics of the cult communities in Melbourne area and surrounding LGAs, we're only interested to look at the index of relative advantage and disadvantage, which broadly measures both advantage and disadvantage categories of income, education, employment, occupation, housing, and other indicators. And the ABS defines this measure broadly in terms of people's access to material and social resources and their ability to participate in society. The ABS defines the ranking of these target areas that we are looking at. A low score indicates relatively greater disadvantage and a lack of advantage in general. For example, an area could have a low score if there are many households with low incomes or many people in unskilled occupation, and few households with high income or few people in skilled occupations. A high score indicates a relative lack of disadvantage and greater advantage in general. All areas are ordered from the lowest to highest score. The area with the lowest score is given a rank of 1. The area with the second lowest score is given a rank of 2, and so on. There are a number of studies that demonstrated a social gradient in gambling losses. They identified the areas of higher socioeconomic disadvantage lose more than the areas of lower socioeconomic disadvantage. There was a study by Rintoul, Livingstone, Miller, and Jolly, 2013, and other studies as well demonstrated similar results. I also looked at the data from the Victorian Responsible Gambling Foundation, where they ranked all the LGAs in Victoria in terms of gambling losses, number of venues, and ranking, safe ranking. I was interested only in the data for Melbourne and surrounding suburbs and LGAs, and there was a pattern where the LGAs with higher numbers of LOT speakers and higher numbers of lower English language proficiency have higher gaming machine density, higher gaming machine expenditure, and lower safer score. When I looked at the data of five LGAs with the highest percentage of people who speak a language other than English, Brimbank, Hume, Greater Dandenong, Monash, and Melbourne, It was identified by looking at data that the LGA with the lower SAFER score spent more on pokies a day, it has higher number of pokies and higher number of venues, higher percentages of people who don't speak English at all or with lower English language skills, such as brain bank. Similar results are for Hume and Greater Dandenong. If we look at Melbourne, we can see that it has higher SAFER ranking, lower percentage of speakers who do not have English language skills, spend less on pokies, has less number of pokies and gambling venues. Mapping the index of relative socio-economic advantage and disadvantage, which is a composite measure of occupational and educational opportunities, house ownership, or rent, compiled at the final level of the Australian Bureau of Statistics, defined statistical areas. It helps us to identify pockets of disadvantage within these suburbs. Now we're looking at Greater Dandenong. The colors used in the map are determined by the quintile that the area falls into. The quintiles are calculated as follows. The lowest scoring 20% of areas are given a quintile number of 1. The second lowest 20% of areas are given a quintile number of 2, and so on, up to the highest 20% of areas, which are given a quintile number of 5. Greater Dandenong is given a lower score, which indicates relatively data disadvantage and a lack of advantage in general. Next, we go to Hume LGA in Melbourne. It's given a score of 3, which means it sits in the middle between the most disadvantage and between the most advantage. Brimbank area, it's given a score of 2. When we look at the index of relative disadvantage only, and are all on the lower quintile, lower score of 1-2, which still they are in the most disadvantaged side. We're going now to move into looking at the psychological theories of acculturation and ethnic or cultural identity help us in developing more understanding of the acculturation and settlement processes of cult communities. And in turn, that may help us in better planning and allocation of gambling counseling services and support services. Cultural psychologists have recognized that acquiring the beliefs, values, and practices of the receiving country does not automatically imply that an immigrant will discard their beliefs, values, and practices of their origin country. Berry developed a model of acculturation in which receiving culture acquisition and heritage culture retention are cast as independent. By asking the questions on what is considered to be of value, is it to develop a relationship with the larger society or to maintain one's cultural heritage? These two dimensions intersect to create 4 acculturation categories or strategies, which are the assimilation, integration, marginalization, and separation. The assimilation adopts the receiving culture and discards the original culture. While the separation is when the migrant rejects the receiving culture and retains their own heritage culture. The integration strategy is when the migrant adopts the receiving culture and at the same time retains their heritage culture. While marginalization is when the migrant rejects both the origin culture and the receiving culture. Although Berry's acculturation studies link both integration and assimilation strategies to better health outcomes, promoting the integration acculturation style is more productive for gambling harm minimization because gambling introduction for newcomers and migrants would occur in the acculturation process to Australian culture. Think to me, it developed a framework the migrants to a new country hold ethnicity to be of importance, which is the ethnic identity salience, and whether the migrant hold their larger culture to be of importance, and that's called the cultural identity salience. Now, how this framework will help us identify better services and better planning by looking at the cultural ethnic identity typology model. We can see here that the cultural identity and ethnic identity, and there are four different dimensions to this model, which are bicultural identity, assimilated identity, ethnic oriented, and marginal identity. We can clearly identify that the bicultural identity provides the best outcome for the migrant to be integrated into the new country and at the same time maintaining their cultural and ethnic heritage. Individuals who favor the ethnic tradition maintenance and at the same time express movement to become an integral part of the larger society, they practice the integration option. And the less effective way of acculturation would be the marginal identity. That happens when the individuals lose ethnic and psychological contact with both their ethnic group and the larger society and experience feelings of alienation. These individuals practice the marginalization option from Berry's acculturation model. By understanding these both concepts of acculturation, the ethnic versus cultural salience models, we can develop more effective policies and also develop cultural competence training for counselors and workers, industry workers, and this type of training must take into account the lived experience of the members of the community. Now, the exposure to gambling as a pastime activity would like to occur during the acculturation process into the new country, Australia. Therefore, we predict that the need for harm minimization and gambling counseling will further increase in Greater Melbourne region and surrounding suburbs, where new migrants will likely settle due to the relative housing affordability. Affordable housing, ethnic food, for example, increase the attractiveness of these diverse suburbs. As these culturally diverse areas overlap with a larger number of electronic gaming machines and venues, the risk for gambling disorder for residents is a great concern. In concluding, there is an increase in cultural diversity in Australia across all states, relative increase in numbers of people who speak a language other than English at home, increase in numbers of people from the cult backgrounds who report lack of English communication skills, and Some areas with the highest numbers of Lot speakers scored lower on the indexes of social advantage and disadvantage ranking, and identified as the areas with highest numbers of AGMs. Therefore, the resources for gambling harm minimization, such as gambling counseling, community education, must target the suburbs in the outskirts where new migrants settle. And these are the references that we used for our study. This concludes our presentation. Thank you very much.